What's up, everybody? How you doing? Bobby Simmons is in the building. As you can see, in the place to be, sitting directly next to me, ladies and gentlemen, it's the one and only Ella Nicole is in the building.
Yes, she is.
Clap it up.
In the building. She is here. Y'all going to find out. Well, first of all, this is Ella Nicole. Let's get that correct. Okay? So you got a few minutes to hang with me?
Yes.
We coming back. We gonna set this straight up.
You get it here. Together.
Check it! Welcome back, everybody. My special guest, Ella Nicole, is in the building. I have to say once again, thank you so much, Ella, for coming in.
Yes.
And let me just let everybody real quick know who Ella Nicole is. Ella Nicole is the daughter of the legendary dance pop diva herself, Cristal Waters.
Yay, mommy.
That's it. Now, actually, today is your mommy's birthday.
Yes, it is. Happy birthday, mommy.
Yes, happy birthday, Miss Cristal. The drink of Cristal Waters.
Hilarious.
Happy birthday to you. Let's get into the fact of how did Ella Nicole find herself singing?
Well, if we're stepping outside of who my mother is.
Right, because we already know, obviously, you know. Yeah.
But with music being in my family, of course, it was all around me. But 90s R&B is really, I love singing at the radio, recording it on my cassette tape. And I think it was about college that I started. There were producers in college. You know, everybody's creative. So we're just writing songs. And I've been writing since I was little. But at this time, I had a producer with me to make the music. And it was just a good time. Then after college, I was part of a band for a short period of time. And then I did some managing. And then I was like, well, I think I'm ready to sing. Mm-hmm. Did some vocal lessons. And I just started. I met my manager, Simone, and she got me in the game quick.
Wow.
Shows back to back. So it's been awesome
and does that work for you? Because some artists don't think that worked for them because social media is so, it's the way of people being stars today now.
Right.
Your manager getting you back-to-back shows so you can craft your art.
Yes.
Does that work for you?
Yeah, it does. I love live band. I love live performance. I love feeling people's energy. So, and then giving them back to them. So, yeah, performing is my favorite thing, second to the studio. Mm. So I know social media is a big thing, but I also like putting me singing, performing on social media, right. You know, and as a slight access to the audience, you know, because it's just words. But them being there is much better for me, much more fulfilling.
All right. Now, of course, you know, your mother and other family members, musicians too, big musicians in your family, that's been in the music industry. You've seen it as a child growing up.
Mm-hmm.
How has the music industry changed, and now that you're in and you're a part of it for your generation?
Well, to your previous point about social media,
right.
I was just talking to somebody about this, how, you know, back in the 90s, you know, you had to know somebody, you had to get on, you had to be on a record label, you had to get your CD to the radio station and everything like that. Now, you can be your own star on social media. All you need is a SoundCloud or YouTube,
yes.
And people, let somebody share your video, a couple people share your video, and then you got all the followers, and then you have a whole audience. So I definitely think it's different. I think it's a good thing in a way. I mean, if you don't have a lot of followers, then you're just like pushing, trying to get them, and then you're like, how do I get them? But I still feel like, though, even if you have a lot of followers, you still have to have that gift and talent, that especially as a performer, that allows for people to come out to your shows and support you and to buy your music too, you know, instead of just getting a double tap on the pictures.
And also being an authentic singer. Now let's be clear to people who probably not familiar with you and your work.
Okay.
Everybody know your mother in dance music.
Yeah.
Why you chose? Because you went a whole nother route. People gotta understand what she do. Like she really. When I say soul music, I'm talking about soul music. And that's not to say that your mother don't do soul.
Right.
But she does more dance.
Yes,
she's more known for dance.
Mm-hmm.
You know, pop dance music.
Right.
You went a whole nother route. You went like a Solange round the block. And we love Solange.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Now, Solange is...
Yeah, the seat at the table, that thing.
Exactly.
Got, I was like, come on, Solange, you know come what I'm saying? Through. Yeah.
You know, so, but what made you decide that this was the route? And you go that route for real. This is not, you're not playing with this route.
You know? I really think on 90s R&B, I love sitting there singing Drew Hill and Silk and all of their songs. I just love belting out. Mm. And I think that passion, it just made my soul come alive. And I wanted to be able to translate that myself.
Right.
And, you know, writing as a kid, you know, you're in love, quote unquote. Mm. So I had tons of love songs. And I think the only way to communicate such a strong emotion as love is to either sing real deep down in your soul or belt it out loud, you know what I mean? Like Whitney Houston or Mariah Carey, anything like that. So I think that's really what got me, the way it made me feel, that type of music.
Right.
Yeah, I just enjoy it.
Well, we definitely hear it in the style of your music. You know, me, I always say like, yo, that whole Jill Scott and Erykah Badu and Solange, and that route definitely needs to continue to stay alive.
Yeah.
Or even Raheem Devon, all those cats, you know, it seems like, it doesn't even seem like that's the route you're definitely in.
Yeah.
Not to kind of stigma you into that category, but you can tell that you're really into the rawness of soul music.
Mm-hmm.
Give us a little insight about your single and the preparation of this album.
Okay. So my first single was Mistake This. Basically, all these songs on my EP now, I've been writing them for years.
Mm.
And I finally, in let's say 2016, like put the finishing touches on it. But they're all personal stories, something I've gone through or something I've seen somebody else go through. And it's all live music. So I have a band in D.C. That we recorded. And my the single that's out now, Heaven Unknown, which is my favorite because it's about happy love. And it makes you feel, I was going for a Summer Rain, Carl Thomas type vibe. And I just wanted people to feel good,
right,
you know, in that happy space in the clouds and all that stuff. We did that in one take. Like, it was amazing. They recorded it, and then I just went in the studio and sang it. And I tried to go back and re-sing it, and me and the engineer were like, nah, I think it's good.
Yeah, sometimes you don't want to touch nothing, especially if it feels good.
Yeah,
you
know? That's exactly what it is. Yeah. So it felt really good. So I'm very proud of this EP. I think it speaks to my artistry. I want to push the limits some more. I love a guitar. I didn't have any guitar on this EP. So I think, you know, in preparation for the album, I'll start writing with a guitar player, and we can rock out just a little bit, you know.
Oh,
add a little funk to it too.
Yeah.
So I'm very, very proud of it and excited about the process.
That's good. Well, I know for a fact, you know, I've only heard a few of the cuts on there. You know, I don't want to lie to you and say I've heard the whole album.
I love honesty.
Yeah, you know, I listened to a few cuts on there. And I'm going to be honest with you, I do like it.
Okay.
I like it a
Thank
lot.
Thank you.
I do know that your album, this EP, the EP sounds way better than Ciara's album.
Okay.
You know, you know, so.
You're not talking about Level Up, are you?
I'm just saying.
Because Ciara was dancing her tail off in that.
What is this? This is a dance video or singing?
She killed it.
All right. You know what, Ellen Nicole?
Level up.
You know what, Ellen Nicole? Listen.
Yes.
I got Ellen Nicole right here. And I'm going to ask Ellen Nicole this one question.
Oh, dear.
And we're going to leave it alone. So you just said Level Up. All right. Everybody's crunked on Level Up.
Yeah, she was dancing.
She could be dancing,
she
right?
She was dancing her tail off.
All right. So can you dance?
Not like Ciara.
Okay, so who's a better dancer? You or Ciara?
Ciara.
Okay, who's a better singer? You or Ciara?
It depends on the ear.
Oh, my God.
It depends on the ear. Everybody's different.
I just said, who's a better dancer? You or Ciara? You quickly said Ciara.
Yes, because I know my dance style, and people aren't going to think I'm a dancer.
And people know your singing style, and they know, wait a minute, that's not a machine. What Ciara's doing.
Oh, so you have a problem with the machine. Her
incorporation. Oh, yeah, I definitely have a problem with Pro Tools, pitching your voice, your vocals. I mean, let's be for real.
Okay.
That don't happen to you.
Okay. But I'm saying, let's talk about the real issue. You're upset that technology is influencing her vocals and her music. You're not.
Of course, shouldn't you?
Once again, I say it's to the ear. Some people might enjoy that type of music with technology involved compared to a different type of music without technology involved.
Right. Is she right? Ella Nicole is right. I'm not going to argue with her on that. Ella Nicole is right. And I'm just going to say, so in other words, then we're saying the audience is lazy. The audience is, you know, the audience just don't want to hear real people belt it out. I mean, like the Mary J. Blige or the Whitney Houston.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying? Or even the late Aretha Franklin's, mm-hmm. the late Natalie Cole's, mm-hmm. all these. You know, you got family Ooh. Members in your family.
Yeah.
These, you know what I'm saying? Who was doing some
too.
Singing.
Yes.
You know?
Sing, yes, they were singing.
But we're going to leave that alone. Ella Nicole, we know Ella Nicole can sing, though, because actually you're going to be at SOB belting it out. Very proud of you. I know your mother's proud of you,
yeah.
too. You know, that you're actually, you know, you're going through the proper channels. You're originally from D.C., no?
Yes.
Yeah, you're from D.C.
Mm-hmm.
But every now and then you reside here in New York City.
No, I live here now.
Oh, you live in New York
yes,
City now?
Yes, I live in New York City.
You love it?
I love it. And it's funny, when I moved here, I was like, I want to perform at SOB.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and so
wow,
now
look
that,
what happened.
The Lord.
There it is.
Now that it's happening, I'm just...
Better let people know the Lord have blessed her.
I'm sorry if I didn't say it loud enough. But
yeah,
the Lord.
Yeah, you better preach it loud enough. The Lord have blessed her with
Lord
the talent
is still blessing
to
me.
Blow and sing her heart out. Because Sierra don't blow and sing her heart out. What do we? What's in the future now for Ella Nicole? Music-wise, though. Because EP is a start.
Yes, EP is a start. That's to get my foot in the door. Mm-hmm. I have something for people to get a taste of my sound. But the album... Yeah, 2019, and this uh-huh. album, I can't wait. I've met some musicians recently who they still love playing music, mm-hmm. and it just vibrates out of them. Like, I was starting to sing, and they just was playing it. I was like, this is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully I get to work with them. They're in the Philly area. And then I also still have my babies back home in D.C., my right. band. So mm-hmm. a collaboration between those two, I think, is going to allow my album to give even more of a true definition of who I am as an artist.
Mm-hmm.
And there'll be a lot of singing.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm listening. You know I'm listening. I'm listening.
There'll be a lot of, you know, truth telling. I love being authentic in my music and writing about stuff that truly speaks to me.
Mm-hmm.
And also that I think that people can listen to and feel. And, you know, I take music as therapy, and I feel like people have emotions that they don't know how to speak on, but once they hear a song or something, they're able to get it out.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope to write different pieces that allow for people to do that also.
Well, good. So everybody, make sure you understand that Ella Nicole, actually, you know what, you do it where people can actually go and find your music.
Once again, my Instagram is _ Ella Nicole. I post everything. I post my journey. So you're welcome to come along with me on this journey
mm-hmm.
that I'm very excited about. But yeah, I'm everywhere.
All right. And real quick, since you write most of your songs,
yes.
or, I mean, actually all of your songs.
Yes.
But it's got to be one song that you're like, this is the one I love.
Oh, Heaven Unknown.
All right.
I love, love, love that song. It just feels so good. And I just... can't get enough of it. I play it all the time.
That's the song that y'all definitely need to listen to.
Yeah.
I love artists that's doing new music,
mm-hmm.
Being different. We need to change the capacity of the music industry as well, musically. Yeah.
Okay.
You know, there's room for everybody. I mean, I know I joke a lot about a lot of things, but there's room for everybody.
Yeah.
Because that's how we saw music in the 80s and 90s grow. Everybody found a home
uh-huh.
for their work and their art.
Okay.
And there's a home for your work.
Thank you.
And your art. And we want to, you know, see you do it more. Now, I am going to say this to Ella Nicole. I know you're leaving me now.
Okay.
But will you promise to come back
of
again?
Of course. Yes.
You see, Ella Nicole say that. She said that.
Did I come back before?
Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
Maybe you only said that because mommy was here and you was
no.
like, I don't want to look like a liar.
I'm not.
Okay. Your manager's here, though.
I would never. What's that?
So.
You going to come to the show?
Well, you said that it's 8:30, right?
Yes. 8.
Okay.
Shows, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you just have to text me what time you come on.
Okay.
And we're not too far from SOB.
Okay.
So.
Are you going to come through?
Yeah, I come through.
Your
I keep
time allows. Okay.
I always keep my word. I always love to see a good show, too.
Okay.
That give me a chance to, you know, to videotape you with my phone. Can I do that?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Videotape you with my phone and tag Sierra. All right, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank.
Sierra, girl, I love you. Okay. I'm enjoying this glow up. Okay, sis? So separate me from that.
Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Ella Nicole in the building.
Hey.
Thank you so much for
Thank
coming
Thank you for having me. It was
and
fun.
Everybody, show her some love and give her that support. We'll be back. I'm just playing, y'all. Peace. Check it.